Here are the horoscopes for the week of the 29th of June to the 5th of July 2015. Now on the 28th, this weekend, we come out of the Mercury retrograde phase, so many of you will be pleased to hear about that. That's been going on since the beginning of May, with the powerful Scorpio full moon kicking things off. So we had direct action followed by retrograde recalibration, and we're just coming out of the third forward phase. So by now, by Monday, it's a really good time to stop and have a look at what you've learnt. If you're not sure, then have a look at what's going on around you in your world, because life does have a way of coming to show you what you're creating. So there's been a long story, lots of catching our mental narrative, lots of catching our limited thinking, our attitude towards health and time, and our attitude towards attachment and flow. So there's been plenty of lessons there, and it does depend where Gemini is in your chart as to where this was all going on. But there should be an awareness now going forwards of what we've learnt, so that we've changed our mind, we've changed the way that we process thought into action, and therefore we've changed our reality and what we're creating. So we come out of that phase, and then this is looking to be a very golden week. So by Tuesday we have a grand trine in fire, and this begins a very wonderful phase because we have Venus and Jupiter in Leo meeting up. So Venus is the heart centre and Jupiter is where we expand and radiate from. Then all we need to do is be in alignment with what really matters to us, and we can take that in, we can give it really good value, we can fire it up with our emotions, which are our transmitters, and we can send it out there. So there's a sense of creativity, radiance, empowerment, confidence and expansion coming up for the whole of the week. We've already been in this phase a little bit, but this gets really to its point this week. So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, all of those days we have Venus and Jupiter in Leo telling us to radiate love, radiate the real core values, because we've caught the mind now, which is where we have been creating from, and now is a time to just be and to radiate that golden power from the heart center and the solar plexus. So really lovely energy permeating the whole week. By the time we get to the 2nd of July, which is Thursday, we have the full moon in Capricorn, so we have even more power coming up there. Now this is looking like a very mighty full moon. We have three pairs of planets all acting together. So first of all, we have the Venus and Jupiter that I've just spoken about, all shining out through that wonderful summer sign of Leo, the lion and his courage. And courage comes from cœur, which is the heart. So we have those two acting in full effect while we have the full moon. But during this full moon, the Sun is met with Mars in Cancer. So the Sun and Mars in Cancer, the Sun and Mars are dynamic, direct masculine forces, and this is where we direct our soul force energy. So the Sun's symbol is a circle and Mars's symbol is a circle with an arrow, and this says take your soul force energy, take your life force and direct it in a meaningful direction. So very catalytic there, but we are in the sign of Cancer. And Cancer is the mother, the oceans, the holding, the womb, the place where we really store our emotional energy, and that's where it can be directed from. So it's a very maternal, gentle holding of that Sun and Mars that we have during this full moon. And a full moon is when the moon is opposite the Sun, so the moon will be in Capricorn, right next to Pluto. So the third pairing is the moon and Pluto in Capricorn, and Capricorn is our purpose and our direction again, but where we put our energy in day by day to actually achieve a longer goal. So it's a much longer, more powerful combination there. And the Moon and Pluto in Capricorn are showing us now, well, we've cleared ourselves up, we've connected with our value, we're radiating that, we're taking our life force energy with the Sun and Mars and actually conceiving and holding our plans. But now we can actually see, well, what's the long range of this? What is it? What mountain do we want to climb? What distant purpose do we want to have? And what do we want to put our power into? because Pluto is the divine masculine, so there feels like a rebalance here of the divine masculine. There's a lot of recalibration these days with people wanting to bring back the divine feminine, but keeping the masculine on a lower level. But the divine feminine, in a way, needs to step into itself and up and back and allow some space for the divine masculine to come forwards. So on the full moon on Thursday, it's a good opportunity to honour the masculine, to think of the positive sides, to allow that power to come back. It doesn't all have to be warrior and protection. It can be honour, discipline and wisdom. So a big, powerful full moon, taking up all that we've learnt and adding to it with that long distance purpose. What did we come here for? What are we putting our back into? And what mountain are we climbing? And can we balance those forces so that we're holding and nurturing in one level with the feminine, and then we're directing that into something of great worth with that Pluto higher masculine? So really powerful, quite comfortable full moon on the Thursday the 2nd. We've gone through a couple of more challenging full moons, and this is one where we can actually find our feet again and set our compass to true north. So by Friday we're beginning to realise that we make real. That's what realise means, to make something real. So what do we realise? Where do we take the material? Where do we actually build something? So very good weekend coming into, where we're looking at what we're creating, why, what the purpose of it is, and what the legacy of it might be. This is restoring something to its former glory. This is creating something that will last. This is actually having that sense of purpose and direction. So when we realise that we realise, then what are we making real on Friday the 3rd? And then finally, by the time we get to Saturday and Sunday the 4th and 5th, the moon has moved to become opposite Venus and Jupiter. And this is a catalytic, this is a sudden change, a sudden realisation. There's a humanitarian aspect to this. So what we're radiating and what we're pulsing out, can we go beyond our own boundaries? Can we actually see where we fit into the bigger picture and where our consciousness contributes to the raising of the collective consciousness? So there may be sudden meetings or sudden ideas or sudden creative spurts that show us that we can put our energy into something that actually elevates the all. So incredibly powerful week to sum things up. We're out of the retrograde phase. We now know ourselves a lot better and we've let go of quite a bit. We've got a chance now to fall into that creativity and to radiate that out with sovereign power. We've got the full moon showing us where we can actually direct that over a long-term phase and create something. And then we've got the chance to look at that realization power, that manifestation power, how we transmute and how we direct that, but with some sudden sparks coming in to take that from the personal to the whole and see that we can actually come together now, clean, sovereign and refreshed, to make something better, bigger, brighter, revolutionary and breakthrough with that moon in Aquarius at the end of the week. So those are the horoscopes for this week, and I'll see you next week. If you'd like a reading to be able to see where you can best put all of your power according to your personal chart, then please do contact me, zoehines7@gmail.com. I'm available in person in Camden or globally on Skype. I would love to sit with you and look at your chart and see where you can take everything that you've learnt and everything that you care about and direct your energies for the best possible results.